Sorry, with permission from chair. I'm a person, I'm from Tata Institute of Social Sciences, and I'm working on minority education for many years. And in fact, I also have... I just have a question. What I'm trying to say is I've even written a paper on Article 30 showing the tug of war between Supreme Court and minority education institution. It has been published in EPW. You can see the tug of war. You know, for everything they have to fight, whether the institution has been established or not, not only the institution has to be established, it has to be administered also. Who is the principal? Who is managing? So many documents. What I'm trying to say is that I have seen, I have been here for 2 hours and I've heard with lots of humbleness the kind of work you all are doing for minorities and minority education. He has told me how much work is being done in Gujarat. But why the statistics not changing? Why still Muslims are educationally backward? Only 2.5% of Muslim women reaches graduation. The minimum number, if you compare it at all India level, all religious community level, minimum percentages of Muslim women. Why? Because the policies are not in favor of Muslims. Maximum Muslims, I mean the question, okay, you all work for Muslims, whatever, then one communal riot takes place and it takes place just before the exams and people cannot appear for exams and all the data comes down. They, Firoz ji batayenge aapko, ki Jogeshwari mein kis tarah se Muslim education of Muslim girl was affected because of communal riots. When the men, when the boys are not studying, how would the girls be allowed to study? And communal riots give rise to insecurity. And this insecurity is killing. I have just finished a study in Mombara ghetto, and over there, there is no good college for Muslim women. And Muslim women are not sent to Mumbai or Thane for education because hamare paas kya bacha hai, bas maan hi to bacha hai. Aur security sabse badi cheez hai. Hum apni women ko kaise bhejte hain? Aur agar padhai hoti hai to Urdu medium school mein, jahan pe bathroom bhi nahi hai, by the way. BMC school mein bathroom nahi hai. Aap log baat kar rahe hain RTE ki. 10 साल में एक भी आरटीई इंस्पेक्शन नहीं हुआ वहां पर. आप लोग बात कर रहे हैं प्ले ग्राउंड होना जरूरी है. इज देयर अ स्पेस इन स्लम एरिया टू हैव प्ले ग्राउंड? व्हाट आर वी ट्राइंग टू से? डोंट स्टार्ट अ स्कूल, अ क्वालिटी स्कूल, अ रिकॉग्नाइज्ड स्कूल विच वुड बी मॉनिटर्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट इन अ स्लम एरिया बिकॉज यू कांट गिव अ लेबोरेटरी एंड यू कांट गिव अ प्ले ग्राउंड. I mean, you say that we should have school, say, in a kilometer of three kilometers, one primary school. Look at Mumbara. How many students stay in 1 kilometer? Can your school, which has a capacity of, say, 150 students in one classroom sitting on the corridor and even in bathroom, you know, in Kausa school, bathroom has been converted into a classroom. And there is no bathroom now in Kausa school. And I can give you the name of the building where the school is. Okay, I mean, what I'm trying to say is that it's high time. Policy making has to take cognizance of the reality. Reality of Muslim poors. We cannot say, sorry, it is challengeable in court. You see, people from very esteemed planning commissions and NCEMEI and everyone is sitting here. It's high time that you take a call on it and you make it more slum-oriented, ghetto-oriented friendly policies. I mean, are we trying to say that these people have no right for education? Speaking here. I had to basically say this, and nothing else. मैं ये बातें सुन रही हूँ और मेरे को जो सबसे बड़ा क्वेश्चन लगा वो यही लगा कि जब इतना काम हो रहा है तो हालत क्यों नहीं सुधर रहे? हालत क्यों नहीं सुधर रहे? इसलिए नहीं सुधर रहे कि हम लोग कोर ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम तक नहीं पहुँच पा रहे हैं. बुरा मत मानिएगा, मैं थोड़े हार्ड ट्रूथ बोल रही हूँ और मुझे पकड़ के पीठ मत डालिएगा, डोंट किल मी, बिकॉज जनरली आई गेट वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग रिएक्शन फ्रॉम द ऑडियंस एंड आई एम वेरी वेरी नर्वस अबाउट इट. यू सी, मुस्लिम इज नॉट वन कैटेगरी, मुस्लिम इज अ हेट्रोजेनियस ग्रुप एंड पीपल लुक एट इट इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेक्ट्स. This is Shia Sikh, this is Sunni Sikh, this is Bora. By the way, Bori education is very good, okay? Memon education is very good. But look at Ansari education, terrible. Absolutely terrible. They're dependent on state resources. And state says, sorry, no resources for you. Despite having NCMEI, they have such conditions they cannot fulfill. You want documents. And where are the documents? All the documents are burned during communal riots, no? How would you produce a ration card? How would you produce a certificate of your education, of your age, your address? You're staying in an illegal building. Majority of ghetto areas have illegal building. You're staying in an illegal building. How would you produce a document which fulfills the requirement for you to have minimum access to government resources? How would you do it? Are you really helping the Muslims? You say that if we make policies for the poor, we are taking care of the minority. Is it true? Policies are, do all poor face communal riots and discrimination kind of situation? Yahan pe ek the na jinhone kaha tha ki bachcho ko school bhej diya gaya, Muslim school bhej diya gaya, because unko bola gaya ki that is the place for you. And when we go to the field and we talk, we hear so many stories of this kind of discrimination. Even in good institution of Bombay, Muslim students have been stated that, sorry, you have your own Haji Sabu Siddiq, why do you want an admission here? It has been stated, and one story stated takes care of the perception of discrimination for centuries. And till you really take care of this perception of discrimination and discrimination, you will not be able to deal with it. I have been in the study group of, Chief Minister's study group to study the causes for educational backwardness among the Muslims. And how much we tried to tell them that such a committee report is okay. You have equal opportunity commission, it's a must. But along with equal opportunity commission, what is required is Anti-Discrimination Act. Agar aapne Anti-Discrimination Act hai, equal opportunity commission jaisi cheez ko effectively khada kar diya. Aap pure world mein dekh lijiye. There is no equal opportunity commission without the support of Anti-Discrimination Act. We could not sell it. We could not sell it to the extent of even bring it to a debatable situation. They were just not ready. We said it is available for, it is prevalent for SCST group. That why can't you give it in the line, in the similar line for Muslims? We could not sell it. They just did not buy because that means action. And we could not bring that kind of change. Jab tak, till there would be things like insecurity. Okay, some private pockets. Okay, they will work and hats off to them. You all are doing good work. But with this good work, can you take care of 20% of Indian population, which is Muslim population? And if you can take care of 20% of Muslim population, then aren't you also disintegrating the population? Ek taraf Muslim belt, ek taraf Hindu belt. Is this the future of India? Are we helping towards building tolerance, which is required for development of any community? And if a community will not develop, how would the nation develop? I mean, there are many important questions and one has to really address it in a very senior manner. And the biggest problem of Muslims is that the community suffers from tremendous polarization, tremendous economic polarization. And who is the decision maker? Decision maker are elite who have been educated, who do not even know the kind of suffering, the kind of problem that the slum dwellers and the poor are undergoing. We went to Mumbra and we went to elite community people, you know, all the corporators and the MLAs and the landlords, and they told us Mumbra has no problems. Only one problem, and that is the problem of infrastructure, roads, cluster building. Very good. Mumbra has no problem. What about the problem of education? Oh, every second house is a as an educational institution, we went to the poor and they said, we want education, we want health. They're not even aware of the fact what kind of education is being given there, what kind of institutions are there. You know, from a very good institution of Mumbra, only 18 people passed SSC exam in 2012, when I was collecting my study, my data. Only 18, 8 to 18. I mean, I just got the information from internet because the school told us 80%, 100% passing out rate. Where is the accountability? No RTE inspection, sir. No RTE inspection. Or RTE inspection hoga kaise? Because 90% of the schools will not fit. They will be forced to be closed down. Do you want the schools to be closed down? I thought that I will bring it to the attention of the government. But do you want the schools to be closed down? Jo thoda ABCD seekh rahe hain, wo bhi band kar de? Seekhna? Aur jyada the school Urdu medium hai. Kyun? Aap dekhte hain, when you go, you do a survey and you see, oh, Muslim wants Urdu. Because maximum students are going for Urdu medium schools. And when you look at the private school, you see that Muslims, NCAER took out its first report on Muslim education in 1984. And they found that Muslim is one group where maximum money is going in private tuitions. Private tuitions, English. There is a desire for formal education. Agar unko private tuition mein, jinka average income rate shayad 2000 hai, 6000 hai, 10000 hai, depending upon the various townships, depending upon the various areas, wo agar itna paisa laga rahe hain for English tuition, means there is a desire for formal education. Sachar committee is also saying it. Phir aap unko kyun Urdu school diye ja rahe hain? Because elite feel that there should be English Urdu medium school. Elite feel we have to conserve. Do the Ansaris, do the poor Muslims feel it? No. They know that they have to learn English. They know that they can't do with so much of conservatism because they want job. Job has to be linked. Where is the attempt to link job? Till you will be able to link job, whether with women's education or with men's education, believe me, it won't progress. There would be some sporadic incidents here or there, but it won't promote. Biggest importance is livelihood. You have to work for it. Or ye polarization jo hai, elite, please give space. Please give space to go and find out what your poor people, poor Sunnis, want and need. Aur jo ek community support hota hai, iske sang itne terms and condition rehte hain ki that also pulls people back. You have to find out. You have to put pressure on the state to make the policies which are more attuned to the requirement of the population, and you have to work towards security. Demand for an anti-discrimination act. Bring them to court. Bring them to jail. Nahi to kuch nahi hone wala. Hum log ye seminars karte rahenge. Maine ye seminars itne attend ki hain. Maine itne in sab cheezon pe paper publish kiye hain. Kuch nahi hone wala. Hame chahiye action. Action in the right direction. Thank you very much.